Well, it's quite a windy day here at the S&S Turbine's secret research and assembly facility. And we happen to have another Afterburner spray ring here. So I've got a chance to show you some of the bits that make up the Afterburner and how they fit together. So let's take a look at those. Okay, right here we have the Afterburner fuel rail segment off of J79-19. Don't mind the wind noise. Here are the connections for each individual fuel rail. 1, 2, 3, 4. And these are independently controlled for a progressive introduction of Afterburner. I'm going to lower this now and we'll take a look through the back. Okay, here's looking through the back. We've got the... This looks like a strut, but it's actually the body of the torch igniter. And these are the rings of the flame holder. Central cone. Now you can see in this rear view that this is the main flame pathway through here, where my hand is. And this little area here, this is where the cooling air flows into that gap in the Afterburner jet pipe that we saw in a previous video. So, this is the rear of this section, and air comes in through from the area of the floor. Don't mind the wind noise. This is a flexible building and it moves around a lot. This fuel manifold is in very good condition. Near new. Those are the fuel spray bars. There's 21 of them. And we had to take one of them out for parts identification purposes. And it's over here. This is your Afterburner fuel spray bar. And what we're going to do is we're going to reinstall this. I'll show you how it goes in and how it hooks up. We've got our spray bar here. And we have our gasket. Gasket on. It just slides in. And as it goes in, we need to make sure the tip goes in that hole. Okay, first thing I'm going to do is put the bolts in just loosely to hold it in place, roughly. Wiggle it around a bit. Okay, now we've got to hook up these four lines, and they're all rigid lines, so it can be a little bit tricky. Let's see how much luck we have today. That one's started. We'll get this one started. Hey, this is going well. This one is started. And that one started. Oh, look at that. All we gotta do now is crank them up. Almost get that one with the fingers. So when this thing is using all the fuel flow it can handle, all four manifolds, all 21 spray bars, it flows 50 gallons per minute. 50 US gallons per minute goes into the Afterburner section of the J79. And that is a lot of fuel. And what I'm not showing you today is the lock wiring of the connections. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then the lock wiring of the two bolts. So it'll be just like these. And that's your installation of your Afterburner spray fuel bar. There's only 20 more to go. Okay, so you've seen an Afterburner in action, and now you've seen how the pieces fit together. So now you're an Afterburner expert. Thanks for watching.